What's Gucci, everybody? I'm back with another video. Today I wanted to cover B-plus trees. Now, to understand any data structure, it's very good to break it down. The good news about B-plus trees is that all its operation, which is search, insertion, and deletion, in terms of big O and efficiency, are all log of n. That's all there is to say about the big O. Now I want to go over what the data structure is. Now, there's a B plus tree, but first I'm going to cover the B tree and then what the B plus tree adds on to it. So a B plus tree, as you can see here, as it says here, a B tree is a self-balancing tree data structure that maintains sorted data and allows searches, sequential access, insertions and deletions in logarithmic time. The B tree generalizes the binary search tree. If you don't know what a binary search tree is, I'll link it in the top right. The B tree generalizes the binary search tree, allowing for nodes with more than two children. Unlike other self-balancing binary search trees, the B tree is well-suited for storage systems that read and write relatively large disks of data, such as disks. It is commonly used in databases and file systems. Okay, now we're going to cover the B plus tree. Now we're going to go over the B plus tree. A B plus tree is an m-ary tree, I'll get to that in a second, with a variable but often large number of children per node. A B plus tree consists of a root, internal nodes, and leaves. The root may either be a leaf node or a node with two or more children. A B plus tree can be viewed as a B tree in which each node contains only keys, not key value pairs, and to which an additional level is added at the bottom with linked leaves. And that is the big difference between a B tree and a B plus tree, is that in a B plus tree, at the very bottom level of any B plus tree, every node is linked together, so you can easily do a range sequential search on all the data in the tree. So in a B plus tree, there's no actual data stored in any other node but the leaf. So only at the very bottom of the tree are the key value pairs stored in the root and internal nodes, meaning everything above the leaves. There are just keys to help you search better and get to the key value pairs at the bottom of the tree. And just to show you a picture, a B tree looks like this. This is a B tree of order 5, which means that at most you can store 4 nodes. In a B plus tree, you can have, this is of order 4, you have, again, every node separated, but then at the very bottom, the leaves, you have each node is a linked list to every other node sequentially from left to right. It could be a singly linked list or a doubly linked list. It's really up to how you implement. Now, to go over how insertion, search, and deletion work, I think it's best to do a visualization. Here we are. I'm going to link this visualization in the description. I think it works very well. So let's start with inserting some nodes. I'm going to insert 4 here. And so when I insert 4, we're just at the root here. And since the root is also a leaf, the key value pair is inserted here. Now I'm going to insert 5. Now I'm going to insert 6. Now notice that this, I put in max degree of 3. That means the most data, the amount of data it can hold in every node is at most 2 pairs. So once I insert a new number, it will flip. What it will do is, I inserted, 4, 5, and once I inserted 6, it then chose the middle node and promoted that to the new root, and then it made 2 new leaves, separating them from left and right. Obviously, everything less than 5 going to the left, and everything greater than 5, greater than or equal to 5, in this case, going to the right. Now, if you notice, 5 is duplicated here, unlike in a B tree. That's because, like I said, the leaves, the bottom rung, stores the key value pairs. So it stores the actual data that you want to find, and all the internal nodes and root actually just help you filter to the leaves. Unlike in a binary search tree, if you found a value, you would just stop in the middle of the tree, or if you found it at the root, you would just stop there. That's not the case in a B plus tree. You would simply be looking at keys, and the keys are helping you find the values always stored at the leaves of the tree. So you're always going to be going to the leaf in a search. So now, if I search for 5, for instance, even though it found 5 at the root, it still went to the bottom to find this value. Because that's where, again, the key of 5 is stored here, and then the actual value of 5 is stored at the leaf, which is what you're trying to get at. Okay, so let me insert a few more values just so you know you can see everything at play. We're going to insert 7 here. This is going to cause the tree to split again. Then let's see, let's insert 3 here. Okay, and then we can insert 2. And now, again, that was a big deal here because once we added 2, it caused 2, 3, and 4 to split. And then it also caused the split of 3, 5, and 6, where it promoted 5 to a new root and then, you know, made left a leaf, made left a internal node and made 6. It promoted 5 as a new root. It made 3 an internal node, and it made 6 an internal node. Now let me, for instance, add 3 again here, and we'll see what happens. We'll notice it goes, starts at the root, goes to left, then adds 3 right there. You can add duplicates, that's fine, because you may be storing, you know, the same keys, but different values of data. And that's basically it. You know, you can mess with it as much as you want, you know, add 1, but as soon as you get that, once you have 3 values, you need to split up in the tree. Once 3 values should fit in a node, then simply you're gonna split that up in the tree, and if splitting up causes that parent node to have 3 values, you simply split up until possibly you have to split the root, and then you create a new root, and then you'll be done there. So again, it's pretty easy. If you look at the Wikipedia page, there also is a great kind of algorithm word salad, I should call it, of how, you know, to program in Python syntax, how to program the search feature. Now deletion, again, we have to delete the leaf node and any keys associated with that. So in this case, I'm gonna try to delete 6 here. And if we notice, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna find 6. And then we also deleted this internal node 6 right here, along with the bottom leaf, because we don't want it sorting by those keys here. If you'll notice here, again, like I said, the arrows at the bottom indicate a linked list, so it's easy to do a range sort on all these queries because, again, you can simply, we have a linked list here, and we could do simply a binary search or a binary find to be able to find all the values between 3 and 5, because we know, you know, the middle is between 3 and 4. Okay, let me just show one more deletion here. Let me delete 1 here. And if I delete 1, that will simply take that 1 out. But since 2 no longer had a left child, it had to promote 3 to be a new key to search by, and then bring down 2 here as a new node and split this node up. Okay, and then I can show find here. We could simply search for 5 just to show you that it doesn't stop at the root. It goes all the way down to the leaf, even though 5 is at the root. Like I said, it's looking for the value, and all values are only stored at the leaves. Well, guys, thanks for talking. Like I said, all the operations are log n time. You can have a, you know, B tree or an m-ary tree or a B plus tree of any degree, of any order. So you could have a tree of 100 order, which means it can store 99 data points in one node. So you would be searching, you know, 100 different ways. It's called an M order tree, meaning you can have 7 possible, you know, children, but you can store M-1 data points in that node. So it's called, you know, an M-ary tree because you can store M-1 things, but you can have M children. Thanks, guys. If you like this video, please give it a like. Helps me out a lot. And tell me the best thing about your day. See you guys.